Citing a lack of clarity, the Stitt Administration is declining to participate in a federal summer food program utilized by thousands of Oklahoma children. Education reporter Taylor Jackson joins us now with more on the reasons why and the impact that decision might have. Taylor.
Rich Oklahoma children in some counties will still get the summer EBT program benefits thanks to the Chickasaw, Choctaw, Cherokee, and Osage Nations. Advocates hope the state will reconsider and participate in the program next summer.
We were disappointed.
Hunger Free Oklahoma President Chris Bernard is talking about his team's reaction to the state opting out of the USDA summer EBT or electronic benefit transfer summer program.
We knew they were hesitant, and honestly, we were hoping even if they didn't submit the letter, maybe we get them there in a month or so. Often these deadlines can be a little soft and they'll let states in. I think over the past week, it's become clear that the governor does not intend to change his mind.
With approximately 400,000 children eligible to receive the summer EBT benefits, many Oklahomans wonder why the state would turn down the program.
Governor Stitt's communication director, Abigail Cave, said one of the main concerns was that states had to express their intent to opt into the program before the rules were even finalized.
Bernard says they will advocate for the state to opt into next year's program.
Also have to pivot and think about what are the ways we can minimize the damage that'll come from. It's taking away a program, so it's not a new resource that would have come in. We've been doing this program since the pandemic started, right? So I know it's been framed a couple different ways, but in reality, these are families who are losing the benefit they have relied on over the last few summers.
The program provides grocery benefits to low-income families with school-aged children during the summer months.
This program brings a huge number of dollars back into the state to address the issue, and does it at a time in particular where other resources are strained during the summer when kids are out of school.
Governor Stitt said he wants every child in the state fed in a statement that read in part, "My administration proudly funds numerous food security programs to the tune of $2 billion per year, and every Oklahoman eligible for the new Biden administration program is already qualified for an existing food security program. I don't want a single Oklahoma child to go hungry, but large duplicative federal programs do not accomplish that goal." But some say the state programs offered aren't enough.
We've got a high food insecurity rate in our state for a reason, and so clearly what we are doing is not enough.
Oklahomans for Public Education founder Angela Little saw firsthand how important summer feeding programs are after helping a neighbor.
My boys, when they were in elementary, had a friend that lived around the corner, single mom of four little boys, and they were in Edmond, that's where we live, you know, they went to Edmond Elementary, and they every day she would go to work, you know, she worked two jobs, and they would come, you know, I would tell the boys, you know, ride your bikes over there and get them, have them come over, and I would feed them every day, and they didn't have anything else otherwise, you know, all day long when they're at home, you know, I mean, not for any fault of hers, she just couldn't afford it.
14% of Oklahoma households are food insecure, according to America's Health Rankings. Little says her group is collaborating with Oklahoma Rural Schools Coalition to help alleviate school lunch debt. She believes the amount of unpaid lunch charges at school should serve as an indicator of how much the state's food insecurity rate is impacting families and school districts.
There was a lot of discussion around outstanding school lunch debt and how much it was plaguing districts. I had no idea, actually, that it was so substantial. And I didn't realize that there was, you know, some districts that had to send these families to collections after, you know, if they didn't get this debt paid off in time.
During the COVID-19 pandemic, school lunch waivers covered the cost of lunches for all students. But in 2022, the waiver ended, leaving many families scrambling to find funds.
We really started to see this being a problem with school districts. For me, myself personally, in my home district of Noble, we saw this being an issue as early as last year. And, you know, what's happening is that there's several reasons why this is happening, but the districts are not getting as much federal reimbursement for those meals as they did down the road.
School lunch prices vary by school district.
Well, my kids eat breakfast and lunch at school on most days, and I think theirs is around $5 a day for both. So you multiply that by multiple kids, and it can be a pretty hefty bill for some families, for sure.
At the end of 2023, rural school districts reached out to Little and Wright for debt assistance. One school had more than $30,000 of school lunch debt.
It blows my mind that this is where we are in the state of Oklahoma, and it makes me very sad that we're not prioritizing the health and nutrition of our children even through the summer months. And for children who are food insecure, the summer months are the hardest ones to deal with because they're not being sent home with backpacks over the weekend with extra food. They're not getting that extra nutrition and services that they need.
Advocates are now looking to lawmakers to help ease the burden of parents during the school year and summer months.
Well, so there are multiple bills out there already on child food security, mostly focused during the school year. So there's bills that say, let's raise the income threshold for free meals and the state will cover the difference. There's a bill that incentivizes school districts to adopt a universal feeding model that it's a federal waiver you can apply for called the community eligibility provision.
We do want to emphasize that the state will still participate in the USDA Summer Food Service Program that serves low-income communities. The EBT Summer Program that the state has opted out of is a separate program. Rich.
Okay, very good information. Thank you, Taylor.